I cannot believe they are finally here. English edition Overdress Start Decks. These are super thin. That's literally the first thing that came to mind when I got these products. Like, look at this, right? Here's like a original, like I still have this for memory sakes, right? An original trial deck. Look how much thinner this is, right? Just match it. It's crazy how much thinner and smaller they are now. Actually, just absolutely insane. But I can't believe it. They finally came. You know, we've been waiting for this for so long. The hype has been super high. And I've heard, honestly, that a lot of people have been going crazy with it as well. I heard from one of my friends, Mega PSK, that in Melbourne at Neko Cards, apparently they had like huge queues just like lined up to buy them. You know, they went through like, I think 48 or something of each start deck that got sold out within like 2 hours or something. It's genuinely insane. So I'm super hyped to see how much just, you know, buzz there is around these products, because this is such a great entry product, right? And also thank you to everyone that came through and watched the choose your start deck video. I worked on that quite a lot, so it's really cool to see a lot of y'all watch it, you know, and you know, kind of help yourself decide which one to actually pick up. And so today we're going to be looking at what is inside the English versions of these five starter decks. So of course, these are the five nations in order. We have Dragon Empire, Dark States here, Keter Sanctuary, Stoikea, and Brandgate, or Brontgate as the ad says. So we'll open them one at a time and just go in the order that they released in. So we're gonna put the other four away for now. And so let's take this first one, Dragon Empire, and get Kraken. All right, so sadly no cool, you know, opening. Here's the back of it though. So you can see here, it shows the entire card list right there. So you can see there, you know, four pieces of most cards, you know, three of certain ones that you don't need too much. So you don't need to worry about it too much. So you get basically four of everything that you care about. Then you have, you know, two new mechanics, Ride Deck and Overtrigger. So of course they really advertise the Overtrigger, you know, front and center. QR code to learn the rules, because there's no rule book inside this. So if you need to learn the rules, scan this QR code. There's also a good video on the official YouTube channel that teaches you the rules in a very nice, clean manner. And then what is Card Fight? Vanguard is also very cool. Of course, the side is very nice. It's very pretty. This is a very neat design, to be honest. And they're so thin. Like, I really like how thin they are, to be honest. Here we have the logo of Dragon Empire as well, right there. And that's basically it. So on the front, you know, it's just UU, Holy Dragon, Featured Nation, Dragon Empire, and, you know, Vanguard Overdress logo and Bushiroad. So yeah, very clean design. I definitely like this quite a lot. So let's just get this open and see what we have inside. I am super stoked for this. You know, like, we have a sneak peek later on today. I will post my sneak peek results tomorrow for you guys as well. Opening up any prize packs and any bonus packs we have left over from the sneak at itself. All right, so let's crack this baby open. Ooh, this is very different from past times. Wow, okay. I'm actually very curious how this is gonna look. So inside there's just like a little plastic pocket. So you can basically, you know, just close this up and put it away. So just like that. So inside we do get a playmat, one-sided playmat with the new zone. So let me actually zoom out to show you this. So here we go. We can just take it all out and you can see here, you know, Vanguard Circle Order Zone here. That's a new addition. Overdress logo, triggers, Ride Deck Zone, also all that kind of stuff. You know, I think a lot of us knew what to expect, you know, because we already saw the Japanese ones. If you want to see my opening of the Japanese trial decks, by the way, or start decks rather, then do feel free to check it out. There'll be a link up here somewhere. But anyway, let's now look at the English one. So it comes in a little plastic pocket like this. So a little bit different than past times, but I do like how neatly this is packaged. So they save on the plastic itself, because they usually have like a fat plastic border around it. But so they saved on that and just put it in a little plastic pocket. So I think that's better, I hope. Let's stay environmentally friendly, y'all. All right, and then as usual, you have this little tab that you just slide off, you know, that holds together the cards. So you take that off and then we see the cards. Of course, each Stark deck comes with one foil version of the main grade 3. So here we have Nirvana. So it looks absolutely fantastic. You know, the foil looks really good, and I'm super glad that the foiling is unlike the Japanese one, because the Japanese one, in my opinion, has actually gotten worse over the years, because in Japan they put like a plastic sheet over the card, so the actual like cardboard feeling of the card disappears from foils. Basically, they don't feel like cardboard, they feel like plastic on the front, and I really don't like that. So I'm really glad that they still have the cardboard feeling on the English ones. This feels way nicer than the Japanese ones. So if anything, English is kind of ahead right now in terms of how nice our cards feel. So they might not be as thick, they're a little bit thinner, but at the same time, they, in my opinion, feel much better as well. So here we have Nirvana. Of course, most of you guys know the skills, but of course, it can revive grade zeros by discarding the card once per turn, and also powers up itself and your overdressed ability unit. So we get four copies of Nirvana. Here's the non-foil, so you can see the color is a bit better. You know, the foil definitely does kind of wash them out a little bit. Here's the back, of course, nothing special, just the usual Vanguard back. Then the grade two of the Rhyme deck, Reyu, so very nice to see. When this unit is rode upon by Chakrabarti, Divine Dragon, Nirvana, Soul Blast 1, search your deck for Verena, reveal it and put it into your hand and shuffle your deck. So very nice to see them in English. Of course, four copies as well, but you only really need one for your overdressed decks, so you don't need to really play four. Then we have four copies of the Rino. So this is the one that searches for your Trickstar. So also very, very nice. And so again, you only really need one, so don't have to worry about playing all four. Some decks do play four, but it's not that frequent. And then we have the Sunrise Egg. So this is your starter, and so when you ride over it, if you go second, you draw an extra card, so that's very nice. And I guess some of you already know that these are like matching arts. So if we take this, I think it matches with the was it with the ladies? No, it was with the, it was Nirvana that matches with the ladies. Sorry, my bad. So I think it goes like this. Yeah, so this is one like matching art piece basically. So just like that. And then the grade zero matches with the triggers. So that's how it went. So yeah, you can see it's one big matching art of six cards, but you know, I'll just show off the four because I think it'll be a bit of a struggle to fit everything into one frame for now. But yeah, so honestly, the Nirvana deck, I'm very surprised by how much I love it. It's honestly one of my favorites right now so far from Overdress. Even though I've never really been a big like dragon person, I do play Narukami, but that's about it. So we have the Inferno Sword. This card isn't very good, just gets plus 2k, so it's a 15k attacker. You know, for a start deck it's fine, but it's definitely a card that you want to replace with the Verena Valiente releasing next week. Then we have the regular Verena, so our overdress card looks super sick in English as well. The border is so clean here and everything, you know, the little lit up eyes. Like, Verena is such a dope design. So of course, overdressing means, you know, putting it over the card it overdresses over, so Trickstar. So overdressing is literally like you have a Trickstar and you put Verena over it. That is overdress. Like, that's literally it. So nothing too complicated, and it gets bonus skills when it is in overdress state, so that's also very cool. So four Verenas, you know, four of every important card, as I said. We have three Anki Bowler. So this is just a vanilla, so definitely, you know, not something you really want to be playing in a full deck. So we got only three copies of it, and you really don't need more. Four Perfect Guards. For those of you returning players, I know some people were really surprised that, you know, Perfect Guards come in four in a cheap $4 start deck, but yep, that's right. That is the reality right now of Vanguard. And of course, four copies of the Trickstar. You do play all four, you know, to always be overdressing, so that's also very nice. It's just a grade zero that cannot be chosen by opponent's card effects, but of course, the whole strength lies within evolution for this one. And then the Overtrigger. So this is my first time seeing an English Overtrigger in person. So of course, Overtriggers give plus 100 million power. They have a little over logo here as well, looks very cool. And let's say you can only have one Overtrigger in a deck, and when revealed as a trigger, you remove it, draw a card, and choose a unit, give it plus 100 million to the end of turn. And then if you reveal it for a drive check, then you activate this additional effect. So if you drive check it, then you activate this effect, but if you like damage check it or draw into it, it doesn't happen, right? So if you drive check it, you give another unit plus 100 million. So that, you know, this Overtrigger is still considered pretty good. It is still played in some decks, especially in like Dark States and stuff. I've seen it play quite a bit. Then we have the critical triggers with the reminder text of what a critical trigger does. So that's also very nice. Looks very cute. Really good art. The colors also look super good. Nothing feels like washed out or like, you know, flushed out or anything. Looks super, super clean. So four draw triggers as well. Then we have three front triggers, but fronts aren't really played that much. So three is definitely more than enough, in my opinion. You will play crits later on when the booster set comes out. Then four heal triggers. This one also looks very nice. The Rona. So very cool. Oh, I guess the name Rona doesn't really go by that well these days, huh? All right, and then finally four of the normal order. So if you guys don't know, if you're returning to Vanguard, a new player, orders are basically like spell cards, and so normal orders are played during your main phase, and you can only play one order per turn. And then blitz orders are like defensive spells that you play during your opponent's battle, so only when your opponent attacks you with one of their cards. So this one's a normal order that you can play in your main phase to count plus one and basically give a unit plus 5k, and then search for a Verena from your drop zone and add it to your hand. So that is basically the Nirvana start deck. So it's a very, very clean package, you know, just has a lot of stuff that you will keep, right? Everything except for this dragon, the grade three, this PGs you'll change as well, but everything else kind of stays, right? And I guess this order also gets taken out, but like updating this deck is honestly not that bad. You just need like one triple rare, one double rare, and like a common, and you're basically good. And the Overtrigger, I guess, as well. So that's Nirvana. So let's put it away for now and look at the second one. And so the second one's going to be, of course, Violence Bruce. So this is Dark State. So this is probably one of my favorite ones to play right now. I really enjoy playing Bruce. It feels very satisfying to, you know, get the right combos going. Like, like and balance your resources well. So if you're really into those kind of decks, like if you're into Gear Chronicle, into Pale Moon, into I would say like even Spike Brothers, you'll definitely enjoy Dark States. It's a very, very fun. Even Nova Grappler, to be honest, it does have, it kind of has like a bit of a feel of Nova Grappler, I would say. Oh, so this pocket is for the playmat. Okay. So I'll know that for now. All right, and then of course let's pull out the actual deck with its little frame here. So that's very, very nice. Oh man, I'm so hyped by the fact that finally these products are out in English. Of course, huge shout out to this sponsor for today's video, parkage.com. So they did, you know, send me these for free, so I'm very, very thankful. And of course, if you want to pick up your own Stark decks, or they also sell singles, right? If you want to update these decks, you can already buy the single cards or the booster boxes from parkage.com, and you can use discount code different5 for a 5% discount at checkout as well. So, you know, just get a bit more bang for your buck basically with that little discount, so it's always very nice. All right, it's time to take a look at Bruce. Mr. Bruce, what do you have to offer for us today? You are definitely one of my favorite decks right now, so I'm very hyped for this. I even have it in Japanese. That's how much I enjoy it. So here's Violence Bruce, the foil. Of course, the final rush mechanic at the start of your ride phase. You final rush, you the player. So specific units get a power up when you are in final rush. And so, for example, he says, when he attacks, if you're in final rush, soul blast 5 and stand your front row rear guard. So very powerful. You do have to wait for the fourth turn to enter final rush, because at the start of the ride phase that you are on Violence Bruce for, but it's a very good card. So four of this is very, very necessary. Then we have four of the Anger Richards. So this guy says, when placed on Anger Circle, put a rear guard into your soul and draw a card. I'm trying to refocus it. It wants to focus here. So yeah. So this card just plays like a one of in your ride deck. That's about it. So you don't really need all four, but it's still nice that you have four. Some decks do play more. Diablo's Bad Steve basically calls out your starter and soul charges, and then in final rush gets plus 5k. Also good in the ride deck, but I wouldn't really play it outside of that. And then of course the starter Innocent Matt, the intern. Then we have the Time Fissuring Fist Colossus. Very cool card with cool art. I did play this card as like at like 3 or 4 copies for a long time, but I did cut it out eventually. I think it's a cool card, but the deck has already a lot of strong attackers from the booster set, so I kind of cut this out over time. But you know, Marjorie just kind of reaches similar numbers and, you know, does more. So yeah, three vanillas. This is the Izer. So this guy, you know, just a vanilla. You will cut him out because it doesn't do anything. Then we have, oh, this is probably one of the best cards from this starter deck. I mean, there's a lot of really good cards, but Brody, this card is really nice because he basically is the only 10k shield card, because when he's put on Guardian Circle, you can kind of must one to give him 5k shield. And this also works when you intercept with him too, so that's also really, really nice. So only comes at 3 copies, so you kind of want to pick up a fourth one from somewhere. So maybe see if anybody in your locals has a spare, or I mean, you can just buy a second one, a copy of the Dark States one. But honestly, I see a lot of people play this at 3, so I think it's fine to play as a 3 of as well. Like, you don't have to play 4. So it's just, I guess I personally been trying to play 4, so that's it. But then this card is definitely like a 3 or 4 of Acrobat Presenter. When he boosts or attacks, if your Vanguard is Bruce, then he soul charges 1, and if you're in final rush, then he soul charges another 1, so you get soul charge 2 from it. And considering that Bruce has to pay soul blast 5 to restand your front row, that's very useful. We got this perfect guard with really fantastic art, but sadly she won't be played because there is a better perfect guard that is a rare from the booster set that works, you know, you don't have to discard for when you have like 1 or less cards in hand. So, you know, a bit of a shame. Wish that art went to that one instead. Same overtrigger as the one in Dragon Empire, so we're not going to go over it. Then, of course, 4 of the criticals. So this one showed up in the anime. Danji reaches her hand. You can see the black gloves she has. So that's basically, you know, an anime moment, I guess. Certified anime moment. The draw trigger, Jake. Very nice. Then we have the front trigger, Killian. She looks very, very good. Her art is pretty nice. If I was streaming right now, the Twitch chat would certainly be popping off at this. And then the heel trigger is Ariana Grande, so very cool. Glad to have her on the stage for Vanguard as well. And then the card that isn't really played in Bruce, but is played in the other Dark States deck, Baromagnus, is Brother's Soul. So it's a normal order that you play during your main phase once per turn. You can soul charge 2. So basically just 2 soul charges for 1 card, which is pretty nice. But in Bruce, you don't really need that much soul charge. Like, you can naturally build up 5 soul all the time, so it's not that much of a struggle. So you don't really need the Brother's Soul. So from these cards, the ones that you'll keep are like all 4 Bruces, one of the Richards for sure, one of the Steves for sure. Starter, of course, goes without saying. Some builds do play the Colossus still, and then definitely the Brody. Again, some builds play Brody, some don't. I'm personally a big fan of Brody. Definitely everyone plays Acrobat Presenter for the time being. PGs do get changed up for the new ones, and then triggers, of course, remain the same outside of like more crits, I guess, and this also gets changed out. So
yeah, Bruce is really good and very cheap as well. Very cheap to upgrade. The pieces, like the cards that you need to upgrade Bruce in the booster set, are really, really affordable compared to some of the other nations. And speaking of nations that are more expensive, Keter Sanctuary. So Keter Sanctuary does have a pretty expensive triple rare in the booster set coming out next week. But Keter Sanctuary is basically, I mean, I didn't really talk about it too much, but, you know, Dragon Empire, of course, is the Dragon Clan, so like Kagura, Narukami, etc. And then, you know, Dark States is like Gear Chronicle, Dark Riders, Pale Moon, and Spike Brothers. And then Keter Sanctuary, of course, is all the Paladin Clans, Genesis, OTT, and Angel Feathers. So you see a bit of those aesthetics represented in all of them. Also didn't show the side here for the Dungey one. It's a very nice color. I like this little, like nice neon blue and pink. It feels like ice cream. I don't know why. But let's open up the Keter one. We do have three more to open, you know, including this one. So I don't want to take too long here. Don't want to drag this video on for half an hour. As much fun as I'm having, you know, you'll be watching me open a lot of stuff because I'm opening not just a case of DBT01, but also I've ordered a lot of extra boxes on top of that because I realized when opening a Japanese product that opening these boxes is way too fun and I want to enjoy it as much as possible. That's basically the TLDR right there. So we'll put away the rest of the start deck here and then let's take a look at Bastion and what he has to offer. So this deck is definitely, if you're a beginner and you want a strong deck, even just the starter deck in my opinion is really powerful. Like this deck is pretty damn strong and it's really not difficult to play whatsoever, so that's a really huge selling point for it. So of course the main grade 3 is Bastion and there's the foil of it as well. So he gives all your grade 3 units plus 2k power, so that gives you, you know, kind of feeling of where this is going. And then at the end of the battle that you drive checked a grade 3, so you know, once per turn only, you can discard a card to choose a rearguard and stand it and give it plus 10k power. So you do need to try drive check grade 3s, so this deck plays a lot of them because the ride deck also depends on grade 3s. So that's another big thing. I love how the foil pattern goes on like the crest of the horse. It's super nice. And like his like chest armor, there's like some people saying in the community that Bastion might be a girl, so that would be a pretty cool twist if that is the case. And of course you do get three copies of the non-foil, so very, very nice. You know, just obviously very beautiful. These cards are just fantastic. Then we have Rooks. This is the grade 2 of the ride deck, so when Bastion rides over him, you reveal three grade 3s from your hand to draw an extra card, and he gets boost plus and plus 5k if you have three more grade 3 units on your board on rearguard circle. So very grade 3 reliant, but the extra draw is very nice as well, so make sure your deck is jam-packed with grade 3s, because this guy also says when he's rode upon by the Rooks, so the grade 2 we just saw, you reveal two grade 3s from your hand to reveal the top card of your deck and call it to rearguard circle if it's a unit card, and reveal it in, and put it into your drop zone if it isn't. So if it's an order, for example, you have to put it into the drop, but you know, most of your deck is normal units, so you will be calling it. And otherwise you can count almost one once per turn to give your vanguard plus 5k. So he's good in the ride deck but not really good on rearguard circle as much. And then he's a starter, the base. I like how his name is just base. Based on what? I don't know. Good question. All right, then we have four of the Ramana. She gets plus 5k when she attacks, if you count boss one. So a grade 3. You'll notice that there's a lot of these in here. We have Refluke, which is still played, by the way. Very good card. You can put him into your soul and give a grade 3 rearguard plus 10k power. So that's really huge. Like, you ask your opponent to guard so much more. You know, if you guys want to learn about guarding and magic numbers and what this plus 10k means, make sure you check out my video on magic numbers and overdress, because that will teach you all the little things about it. All right, then we have the Vanilla. So this one is not played in the main deck, but her art is super nice. It's a bit of a shame that she's just a vanilla, to be honest. This card is good in premium, Platinum Wolf, so sold us 2 to get 5k. Not once per turn, by the way, so you can do it multiple times. Stonks, just two copies though, so keep that in mind. Then we have four of the Kurabiel. I love this PG art so much. So unfortunately, she does get replaced because there is a better Perfect Guard in the booster set that is only a rare, so it's super easy to get. Like, you pull generally like one of each Perfect Guard per booster box, so it's actually pretty wild. But she is a Sentinel, she's a Perfect Guard, so for those of you starting out, very, very important. And then of course Over Trigger that we've seen already many times, critical triggers. So these are the Gurgant, not to be confused with Gurgwit. Then we have the Gallus, the draw trigger four times. And then this front trigger, drawn by one of my favorite illustrators, Fuzi Choco, looks very pretty. Leaf, like the Fire Emblem protagonist. And then we have, oh, I guess, no, Leaf is also what Alphonse's, like, dead form. Spoilers for heroes if you haven't played in 3 years. Arches, what a nice name. So that's the heal trigger. She's very pretty. I like her a lot. And then finally, the order for this deck is the Hour of Holy Judgment Cometh. So pretty cool name, but this card is basically Pot of Greed. So you count them as two. It's a grade three. So you can only play it when you're grade three or, you know, higher, but you don't go higher than grade three. And then you draw two cards and give a unit plus 5k. So it's quite literally Pot of Greed. Very cool. Good order. And it counts as a grade three. Like when you have to reveal grade threes or check grade threes for these guys' effects, it does count as one of them. So that's very, very good. So from this Stark deck, of course, you're keeping the Bastions, keeping one of the Rooks, keeping one of the Forts, and of course the Starter. This gets cut out, but the Raflok does stay, and then PGs get replaced, and then the triggers of course stay the same, and this order is also played, at least at a few copies. So quite a few things in this deck do change. There are better grade threes in the booster set, especially the triple rare and the double rare. They're super, super good, but the triple rare does have its own little price tag on it, so that's something you gotta keep in mind there. All right, and now for the best girl segment. So I also have a separate video opening up this one and the Brantgate one in Japanese, so you can check that out right here. So do give it a peep. But this is Stoikeia. So this is Megumi's deck. So this one, I first started out not really liking it, to be honest, but I personally do enjoy the playstyle. It's very quick. It's very resource like management heavy, and it really teaches you how to like balance your resources to not like counterblast too much, make sure you don't like, you know, soul blast too much and stuff like that. So it's a very cool deck in its own right because of that, and so I'm a big, big fan. So let's just get this out. Zoop zoop, there we go. All right, so I'll just move it out of the cardboard frame and open up the plastic sheet. All right, so zoop, pull that off, and let's take a look at the cards. So Magnolia, of course, only has one skill. End of the battle that she attacked, countless one, and choose a rear guard. Until end of turn, it can attack from the back row and it gets plus 5k power. And if you persona row this turn, which is, you know, by riding the same card over itself, then you can give three units that skill instead of one. So it's really big. And of course, you get one copy of the foil and three copies of the non-foil. The colors are a lot more like deep, or not deep, like more dark on the foil one, it seems, and I think that's how they're supposed to be. So this one is a lot lighter, so pretty interesting how that is, but it does like match the rest of the cards pretty well. So maybe just the foil that looks like that, I'm not really sure. Anyway, Lattice here, when wrote upon by Magnolia, soul blast one to call the top card of your deck or put it into your hand if it's not a unit card, so that's pretty cool. And from back row, can attack with 20k power for soul blasting one, so that's also quite good indeed. 20k attacks, you know, if you allow it to attack from the back row, you know, with Magnolia, it's a 25k attack. So that's 15k shield you're asking for. Karis, you know, Bulbalax. This is Bulbasaur with Bulbalax. I mean, Bulbasaur's back on Snorlax, basically, is why we call it Bulbalax. So this is, you know, the grade 1 of the ride deck. Basically, when you ride the grade 2 over it, you can call the top card of your deck if it's a grade 2 or less. Otherwise, it goes to your soul. And then from the back row, when he attacks, he gets plus 5k. So a lot of back row attack enablers. Lotte is the starter. They all do the same skill when rode upon. If you go second, draw a card. Three of the 10k vanilla. So this one will not be played. It's just a vanilla. Does look cool though. It's a bug in a suit. I do respect that. You know, that's how I feel some days. Then we have Duger. I love this name. Just Duger. If you have four more other rear guards, he gets plus 5k in rear guard circle. He's actually a good card because you can make easy 23k columns with him, especially if you don't persona ride. So he will be played in the main deck for sure. The Stomalia, can almost one, soul plus one, gets plus 5k in boost for the turn. Pretty decent card. She's okay. She's played sometimes. And then this card, Cyrus, once per turn, soul blast two. Reveal the top card of your deck. If it's a unit card, call it. If it isn't, goes to your hand. So in theory, this is a nice card, but soul blast two is pretty expensive, to be honest, because this deck already soul blasts a lot. Then we have four of this PG, very Neo Nectar looking, so does get replaced though, Sag. Then we have the over trigger that we've seen here, four of the critical trigger, so very nice art. They're all very nice, like, you know, I talked about in my video, very Animal Kingdom aesthetic. We got a squirrel, we got a monkey, we got a deer, so we literally have a bit of every animal. And then here we have two of a different type of order. So both of these last two have different types of orders, right? We saw just normal orders until now. These ones have blitz orders. So you can see here it says at the bottom right there, you can see there it says blitz order. So blitz orders, it even says on the card itself, can only be played when you would call a guardian, aka when you defend from your opponent's attack. So you choose a unit, give 5k until end of that battle, and if you have three or more back row rear guards, gets plus 15k instead. So it's like a 15k shield or a 5k shield depending on what your field is. So it's definitely a nice card. Like, definitely very, very cool. So I was really happy when they revealed this, because it meant that they're doing more defensive cards, and they definitely showed a lot of them, a lot of cool ones in the booster sets. I'm very happy about that. So from this, you will put into the main deck four Magnolia, of course, one or more Lattice. It's, you know, kind of, it's up and down. One or more Karas, also being figured out. Starter, of course, this will not be in the main deck. This will be a four of in the main deck, or three of. This doesn't really make it in, and this one is a bit too Soul Blast expensive. PGs do get replaced, and, you know, triggers, of course, stay. And then the Blitz Order is good, but there's better ones, and there are also commons in the main booster set, so that's gonna be played instead. And now finally, it is time for Best Girl Tomari's Brand Gate start deck. So the Aurora Valkyrie. So this deck is definitely, if you like control, if you like to give your opponent a hard time, this is the deck for you, because boy oh boy does this deck do that. So let's take a look, our final one. So here are the sides of it. I don't think I showed the one for Megumi, so here it is. It's very green. This one is more like it's like, this one's also like ice cream. This one's like vanilla ice cream kind of feeling to me, so I do like it a lot. So here's the back again. So you always get the card list on the back, so not gonna go over it every single time. But yeah, so huge shout out to Park Gage for sending me these. You know, very, very nice. I'm glad I got them on release day as well. You know, perfect timing with the shipment and everything. So super, super happy about that. All right, let's get cracking. I am super excited about this. You know, this is by far my favorite nation so far. You know, I'm a Dimension Police main, and I love Nova Grappler, and I love Link Joker as well. So when you put everything into one nation, I'll be pretty happy. So here is Aurora Battle Princess Seraph Snow. Looks super nice. So her effect is, during your turn, if one or more of your opponent's cards are imprisoned in your prison, she gets plus 10k power. And if three or more cards are imprisoned, this unit gets drive plus one. And then her second skill says, once per turn, count plus one, choose two of your opponent's fear cards and imprison them in your prison. What is a prison? Well, I'm glad you asked, because Galaxy Central Prison Galactylus is a prison. So it's a, you can see here, set order slash prison. So what this is, it's a grade one, so you can play it on turn one. To play it, you have to rest one of your units, and then when you play it, you soul charge three, and it stays in your order zone, which is like above your damage zone. And then when in the order zone, when your opponent can, like, during a timing where they can call rear guards, aka the main phase, they can do the following. They can soul blast one to choose one of their imprisoned cards and call it to rear guard circle, or they can counter blast one to choose two imprisoned cards and call them to rear guard circle. So basically, you use your effects to put your opponent's cards into your prison, and then your opponent must pay attacks like Soul Blast or Counter Blast to get them back. So her skill, Counter Blast 1, to choose two cards to put into their prison. So of course the opponent can play around that, but it's really, really nice. So we have, of course, as usual, one foil and three non-foils. That's very, very cool. Then we have the Risat Pink. When she's placed on Vanguard Circle, your opponent chooses a card from their hand and imprisons it in your prison. So hand imprison. I hope they print more of this in the future, but you know, you get four, but you only really need one for your ride deck, and that's it. The one card that you would need more, in my opinion, is the Kyanite Blue. So she says, when placed on Vanguard Circle, search your deck for a prison and reveal it and put it into your hand. So literally, just by writing her, you get the prison into your hand, which is super cool. And when she's placed on Rearguard Circle, then if your opponent has at least one card imprisoned in your prison, you count plus one, soul plus one to draw a card. I think this card is really good, because extra draw never hurts, especially for a deck like this that is more like control-y, so you always stall more by default. So she's a very nice art. I know a lot of people like her art a lot. Here's the starter, Ruby Red. So we're kind of themed after like Super Sentai, like police magic girl, kind of. So yeah, that's the sort of theme that they have. But of course, you know, this is Brand Gate. There are robots in there as well. Alert Guard Gunner is an on-hit to imprison two rear guards. Then we have Security Patroller. Looks very cool as well. On-play Soul Blast 1 to imprison one of your opponent's rear guards. Also very, very nice card for the start deck. We have Jewelion, just a vanilla, but, you know, a super robot. So I'm very happy about that. We have a Roomba even. Look at that. It's just a Roomba. Autonomic. Caution. If one or more of your opponent's cards is imprisoned in your prison, gets plus 2k power and plus 5k shield. So 10k shield is actually pretty decent. You know, I can see playing this, but of course, you know, with these cards that gain shield, if your opponent like pays attacks and like frees everything from their prison, then this card doesn't gain its shield anymore. So you have to use it pretty wisely. Be careful with the timings. Four of the PGs, it's a Kaiju. Gear Grand looks pretty cool, but it does get replaced with the booster set one. Then we have one Over Trigger that we've seen in every single one. Four of the Critical Trigger, Loris Yellow. I was curious how they would translate her name. Then we have the Amy orange draw trigger. Looks very cool as well. And then the Fronte Rose. You know, there's a front trigger. Oh yeah, I haven't even mentioned them. If you haven't played for a while in Vanguard, there are front triggers now that when you check them, buff up your entire front row. So your front row rear guards get buffed as well. So they're pretty okay triggers. They're not that great. Not as good as criticals, heals, you know, or even draw sometimes. And then Truce Green is the heal trigger. It looks very nice as well. And then you get two of the prison set orders. So that is the deck. And so those are the five start decks. And so this has been a very, very fun experience. I'm so glad that they finally released these. You know, Overdress has finally officially kicked off in English as well. And so that is definitely worth celebrating. You know, I think a lot of us have been waiting for this for a very long time. And so this is really a huge breath of fresh air or breath of life even into Vanguard. And so a lot of people are super hyped about it. So, you know, make sure you reach out to your local game stores, you know, go to locals, play. Or if you don't have a local, then at least play in online communities. You know, my Discord has its own community as well. Or, you know, just come through and hang out, you know, whether it's on streams or, you know, Facebook groups or Twitters, etc. It's always, you know, this community is really, really great. And so hopefully the new players coming in with Overdress now have a great time as well. But anyway, y'all, thank you so much for watching. If you guys liked what I do consider subscribing. It does help the channel, and you'll share these videos with your friends as well. But that's going to be it for me today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.